Welcome to HeArtfully Creating, heartfullycreating.blogspot.com. We're going to talk about inspiration today. Now, flowers inspire and have always inspired me, along with many, many artists, and maybe even you. So I want to share today one of my favorite subjects that inspire me in many, many ways. So come and see, and I hope you'll be inspired to create too. Now, all the photos in my vlogs, including all the ones you're going to see today of real flowers from our garden, from bouquets and whatnot, have been taken by me, Anita Berglund. I'm not a professional photographer, so I want to show you how you can take photos that look just as beautiful as a professional photographer. The reason why I took the photos the way I did is because I wanted to capture them the way I wanted to paint them. So I'm going to show the real photos of many of the flowers that I then captured or interpreted in either an illustration or primarily in acrylic paint. So I hope that you're inspired, and I hope that you'll try taking your own photos as well. Whether it's just to enjoy the photos themselves, that is a work of art, photos, as well as capturing the photos to have a reference photo to paint or draw from or create from, even if it's not in two dimension but in three dimensional things like polymer clay or sculpting. So have a look. Now I have to tell you, there's an artist that inspired me to paint poppies, gorgeous oriental poppies, these red ones. Her name is Georgia O'Keeffe. I strongly suggest that you research this artist. Incredible close-ups of flowers. And she was one of my major inspirations when it came to painting poppies. So here are some actual photos that you've just looked at. And here's one of my first illustrations when I was Anita Harris that I used to make a greeting card. And here's some of my early photographs of acrylic paintings of poppies, along with some details. So I'm just going to shut up now so you can just watch. This one is halfway done. And then the next one, you can see it's all done. So sometimes just pause if you want to look at details. Painting can be done in multiple canvases. This one is hanging actually in my sister's home, but I needed to fix the center, so I was able to get the center canvas and retweak it. As many artists are, I'm my own worst critic, so I like to fix things, and because sometimes you look back and you think, hey, I could do that differently. And here's a couple things I did with some of my early poppy cane things that I made out of polymer clay. I'll talk about canes in another video regarding polymer clay. But you slice them, and I just put them on cans and bake them. And you can make some really cool gifts. Pen holders, brush holders, any kind of holder, just a tin can or a glass jar. So these are some basic poppy designs that I did that I took slices off of something called a cane. Loving oriental poppies so much, I looked up on the internet, my number one source for learning how to do things, and I created taffeta poppies to decorate our home. Taffeta is a type of a synthetic fabric. So here they are. I love them. They were a lot of work, but they were great fun. And then some that kind of look like a different type of poppy to me. These were for like hair clips and things like that. Is an Icelandic poppy that I did in acrylic paint, and this is a Himalayan poppy. I don't have photos of it because we don't have Himalayan blue poppies here, but I found a picture to paint from on the internet. And here's something called an Asiatic lily. We've all heard of tiger lilies, these ones don't have spots, so I think they're Asiatic. And here's one of my original, just a drawing I did for a card, an illustration. And here is an acrylic painting of a tiger lily. You know, it's a tiger lily because of the spots. I'm not sure why that's not a tiger, but hey, they call it a tiger lily. Favorite flower is a pansy. Here is my favorite cat ever. Is my sister's family's cat named Leon, looking at one of my pansy paintings in progress. And here are some other pansy paintings that I did. Unfortunately, for some reason, I can't find my photos that I worked from, but here's just some of the paintings. And here it is, July 2015, and the peonies are in blossom right now. These pictures were taken a while ago, but they're from my friend Jan's garden. She has since gone to heaven, and her peonies inspired me to paint a couple of, well, actually not a couple, this painting, and I've just taken a couple of close-ups of it. And flowers do not have to be made into the exact species. If you're creating, whether it's fabric, paint, or wire, or clay, or whatever, I made these for my Etsy shop, a BERGIE Creation, to make as hair clips, pins, whatever you want. So here's some photo sheets I put together for my shop, and a couple of the flowers that I made out of satin and candles and fire. So don't do this at home, kids, to melt the edges. Don't ever, ever melt or burn cotton fabric. Make sure it's synthetic and that you have an adult around. The bottom line is, have fun and be safe. And here are daisies. We all know what daisies are. Daisies inspire just the typical flower shape, a center and some petals. So here's some clay, one of my very first clay pins that I made, a clay cane in process of a flower. You see how it's like a log and then you slice into it, and that's what I put on those cans for the poppy. Here's a texture sheet I made for clay, just again in a similar daisy shape. A really cool ring made out of wire and nail polish. I'm going to discuss more about that on another date, hopefully, about how to do that. And then, what's this? We all know the happy sunflower. When left to overripen, we get the sunflowers that we get to snack on at baseball games. So I've painted a lot of sunflowers in my time. Most of them I've actually sold or given away. So these are all acrylic paintings, and there's about three or four different ones, but I've done a lot of sunflowers. Most paintings I tend to only do one of, but sunflowers are a popular flower. This photo actually was taken by my mom just recently, but I did paint lilacs for probably about 5 or 6 years ago. So here's a painting of lilacs with the detail. I was like zooming in on the details so you can see the layers of color and the brush strokes. And here is a really pretty striped tulip that inspired this. Actually, this is one of my most favorite paintings. I sold it, so I don't have any more, but thank goodness we have cameras so we can record our images. Make sure you take pictures of your creations before you give them away. It's always nice to have a record. And here's some of my paintings hanging actually in Starbucks coffee shop about 5 or 6 years ago. So, and I did receive an Ontario Arts Council grant, so I had to label everything so that they knew that, and they got credit for providing me with some funding to be able to paint. Imagine that. It's awesome. Couldn't decide what flower I wanted to paint this time, so why not? I did many in one. Give it a try. Another favorite flower is the Gerbera or Gerber daisy. I've only done one or two paintings of those, but I really want to try to replicate some in polymer clay or be inspired by them. And now we have some petunias. Again, another painting I don't have, but I have a photo of it. I was gifted it, and a Cosmo, which is one of my friend's favorite flowers. So when she was sick, I got the idea to make a gift by trying to paint on a rock. So you'll see, I was painting on this rock, just a small rock, put one of her favorite Cosmo flowers in the pink form, because they come in pink. So the flower from my garden inspired, made a little gift for my friend when she was sick in the hospital, and since she has gone on to be with the Lord. But it's a good gift idea. George O'Keefe. I love doing macro photography or close-ups of flowers. I like the detail. I'm not a fan of taking photos of bouquets, but if you like that, go for it. I just really like getting close-ups because that's, in my mind, what I ideally would like to paint or focus on if I was doing it in clay or wire or whatever, or drawing. Cards using drawings of roses, illustrations. These are my polymer clay roses that I've recently done, and they took days to do, but were so much fun. And like I said, you need to be inspired by something. And to be inspired means it moves you to want to create. So I'm not very good at if someone said, can you make me a petunia, whatever, and say if I despise petunias or I just don't feel moved to do them, I wouldn't be able to do a very good job. I have to be inspired by the subject that I'm going to create or emulate or not copy. But yeah, so be inspired. You need to be inspired and love the color, love the shape, and have fun with it, play around with it. It doesn't have to look like these are sort of like roses, but it's okay that they're not supposed to. You're the artist, so you're creating. God already did the perfect work of making the perfect flowers. So because we're made in his image, we have this desire to create. So it only makes sense that we get to have fun with our creation as well. He made it perfect, we get to play around with it. Of course, he did it perfect, so it's not like we're fixing it, but you know what I mean. So have fun. And these are some little girl earrings that I did that were in my shop a long time ago. So these are beads that were already made in the shape of flowers. I did not make the shapes of those glass beads or these flower sequins, but just some more ideas. This is called a clematis, and that's another classic shape that I guess subconsciously inspired me to make these polymer clay pieces. So they're not actually clematises, they're clemati. They're just flowers that kind of look like that. And I'm just going to run through and stop yapping, just let you look at the rest of the photos. And you'll notice that there's other photos that don't have a painting with them, but I love the flowers and I actually love the photos and how they turned out. So I'm hoping that they would inspire you to capture what inspires you in a photo so that you can refer to it later to draw, paint, play, wire art, whatever you want to do, or just look at your beautiful pictures. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you. technically a weed, but it's a gorgeous, I think, Scottish thistle. We had one that grew to about 8 feet tall. So it's beautiful. Just wanted to share that with you. Oh, and here's another idea. I turned an old jewelry box into a gift for a young friend using flowers and whatever designs came to mind. So I hope you were inspired. So thanks for joining me today at Heartfully Creating. And thanks for watching. Please subscribe, comment, like, and share these videos. It really helps me a lot if you pass them around. If you like them, if you don't like them, then hey, you don't have to watch them again. But thanks for taking the time to watch it anyway. I would love to see your pictures, videos, your comments, if you've been inspired and what you like to create, or if you have any questions of what you'd like to see. Thank you. Have a great day. Thank you.